introduction. Like I said, my name is Nana. Can you introduce yourselves?
I'm Nando.
Hey,
I'm Manu.
I'm Jack.
I'm Andrea.
Thank you. So where are you guys from?
Milan.
Milan?
Yeah.
Okay, lovely. So what I'm doing is like a short documentary. It's on the gospel, like it's on the word of God. And I just wanted to know, as well as sharing, I wanted to know a little bit more about what you think and what your views are as well. Yeah? Okay, perfect. So first thing I'd like to ask, this segment is called What Do You Know About the Word? And the word is the Bible. So my question to you is, do you guys know what the Ten Commandments are?
Yeah.
You do? And if so, can you name them for me?
For example, don't kill.
Do not kill, that's an English.
Do not steal.
Do not steal, yeah, that's the second one.
Do not desire the other ones.
Is that adultery? Okay, you said adultery and you said do not covet, which means do not think of others as a big name.
Say not the name.
Yeah, don't use the name of the Lord in vain, absolutely.
Respect the father and the mother.
Honor your mother and father, yeah, perfect. Your English is perfect.
Sì, dillo.
What's that one?
You can don't celebrate another god.
Exactly. Do not worship another god. Yeah, yeah. There are three more.
Sorella, ricordati di santificare le feste.
Bravo.
Remember to sanctify.
Non rubare, non uccidere.
Do not kill.
Yeah.
Do not steal.
Yeah.
No adultery.
Yeah.
Do not covet.
Yeah.
As in, do not desire the things of your neighbors. One of you guys said that. Honor your mother and your father.
Yeah.
Keep the Sabbath day holy.
Yeah. Onora al padre e la madre.
L'ho già detto.
He said that. I think he said that. Do not worship any other gods.
Yeah.
Do not use the name of the Lord in vain.
Yeah.
And then there's two more.
You can't remember.
Okay, I will give you one of them.
Okay.
And it says, do not make for yourself an idol.
Oh, okay.
So apart from worshipping another god, do not make an idol for yourself. And then do you know where the Ten Commandments are in the Bible?
Ten Commandments?
Do you know where they are? Like, they're blessed. Okay, it's in Exodus 20. So I'm going to go through them again and then I'll add the final one when I get there. So keep the Sabbath day holy.
Yeah.
Do not covet and do not desire the things of your neighbours.
Yeah.
The one that was missing is do not bear false witness against your neighbour, as in do not testify against their scriptures, like Bible scriptures. Not really. Okay, what is your knowledge of God? What do you know about God?
Bye.
This is a question for him.
Yeah.
He has the most knowledge.
I think that God, like we named him. I think God is only a name.
You think God is only a name for him?
It's only a name, but he doesn't exist.
You don't believe in God?
No, I believe in something else.
You do believe in something?
I believe. I'm agnostic.
You're agnostic?
Yeah.
So that would mean you don't really know what exists. I think agnostic is not really knowing.
Yeah.
Not exactly knowing, as opposed to being an atheist who doesn't believe in God at all. So you think there is a higher being? Or
I try to search something.
Yeah.
But I think God is not real.
You don't believe in God?
Yeah. I know.
It's not what
So you're searching to find out.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you believe in Jesus?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Do all of you believe in God or do you not believe in God?
He was only a man, I think. A revolutionary man, but only a man.
You just think he was a new man, didn't perform any miracles, you don't believe?
No, I don't think so.
No. Okay. How do you think we got here?
Wow.
What?
How do you think you came to be on this earth?
Get you a jump for them.
If you get my meaning.
Very good question.
Maybe for
our life.
To live our lives.
Yeah.
Okay, there's a scripture I want to share with you. It's Jeremiah 29:11, because I believe in God.
Yeah.
It says, for he knows the plans that he has for us, to prosper us and not to harm us, to give us hope and a future. And this is what I believe. I believe he's placed us here for a purpose. Like, we all have an individual purpose, but we have to find out what it is. And I believe you can only find that out through God. Now, what one of my questions usually is to people who say they don't believe in God, or anyone who says that they don't believe in God, or they believe in something else,
which is
how do they believe we got here? Because the only way I can believe that we got here is through a supernatural power, a supernatural being. Because it's not possible for me, for example, to create us all and to create all of this, the skies and the earth, if you get what I mean. So I want to know how you think we got here, like all of this, the sky, the earth, how you think it was positioned, like how you think it came into existence. If you get what I mean. Craig, you can share your opinion as well if you want to, if you think you have an answer.
No?
I have to say that maybe we are too much materialist.
We're too materialistic?
Yeah.
As individuals, as people?
Yeah.
Well, why do you think? I think, you know, like one of the Ten Commandments is do not covet, and do not want the things of your neighbors. Do you mean like that? We just want to keep on acquiring things and buying, and is that what you mean by we're too materialistic?
Yeah. That's in thoughts, not in...
In mind.
Yeah, in mind.
Yeah.
Maybe we are too much materialist, I think.
When things are good, we think that is
God.
No.
Oh. Okay.
That is not God, but that is right. That things are good. When things are bad, we need someone.
Oh,
we need
so
someone.
Call
some
God.
Help or some.
I see exactly what you're saying. Like the Bible says, in all things give thanks. For some people, when things are going good, they're like, yeah, things are great. They don't really think about anything else. But then when things are bad, you think they need someone to call on.
Yeah.
So they call on God. Even if they say they don't believe in him, they still call on him.
Yeah.
Why would that be? Because if you don't really believe in someone or something, why do you even bother acknowledging it? Shield themselves from the truth and then kind of wait until the end to find out what it is.
Somewhat.
Yeah. Why do you think that is? Like, what do you think the reason is behind it?
I think that it's education.
It's education. It's all about knowledge.
Education and knowledge.
In regards to
God.
Yeah. How do you think you find out? For those who do not believe, how do you think you find out that there is a God? How do you find out?
Maybe I think it's inside yourself.
You will only find out inside of yourself? Is it if you ask yourself questions, that's how you find out?
So maybe you have to believe in God.
In order to find out.
Every time. If things are good or things are bad.
That's true. The Bible says in all things give thanks. The way to find out if there is a God, the only way to find out is to believe, one, and to talk to him and communicate. And through that, you will get your response. But it's up to the individual, whether it's in good times or in bad times. If you want to find out, that's the only way you can. There's no other way to find out. You would have to ask questions. You would actually have to speak. Thank you guys so much for your time. I really, really did enjoy speaking to you. It's been lovely. I love your accents as well, and you all look amazing. So thank you so much for your time.